afternoon, Geek Culture. We are here at Comicpalooza. We have a special treat this afternoon. I've got David George and Justin Harder, the animator and the artist for the end credits of the Deadpool movie. How exciting is that? Guys, this is your first con?
Yes, together. Yes, together at last.
Yes. And how are you guys enjoying it?
It's great.
Yeah, I've only done cons in Southern California so far. So coming back to Texas, I was raised in the woodlands. So I've been here all my life. Coming back for the first one, just killer.
So you guys are both Texans by birth?
I'm Kentucky.
Yeah. No, I'm in Illinois, but I grew up in Texas. But I met him in Dallas, and so that's the connection. That's the connection here. Yeah.
Fantastic. So, how fast are the Deadpool drawings that you guys did flying off the shelves?
I have none left.
None left?
No. So, I have some. You guys want to...
So, what's next? You guys were talking about First Studio. You were talking about a little work you did on Lord of the Dark World.
Yes. The project came to us through Blur, and that's who Tim Miller's the director, and he owns that studio. But enough about them. They asked me to pitch on the credits. And Dave is an animator, so once my pitch of my illustrations got accepted, that's when I went nuts, and they contacted Dave. And then Dave got on, and he added a lot more brilliance because of the timing and the kind of works and the nuances of that character's animations were Dave's.
Right up my alley, so character animation and style of humor, that Wile E. Coyote kind of red ball. Right up my alley.
And the animation, the artwork worked beautifully with that.
Yeah, I thought a guy here named Jeff Fowler goes, the saxophone gag, we had it later on, he goes, it needs to be front and center. And so I was like, as soon as that came up, and, you know, I'm drawing things, I'm sending them to him, I'm working from home, my home studio, Claus, I'm sending them in, and then I see the cuts that they're putting together, and I see that as soon as that saxophone comes in first, I was cracking up and I drew it, and that never happened, because I know it's going to come. And then he has to come in and kind of scoot across the frame, and then come back in and kind of hump a little bit. You're going, damn it, that is funny.
And it was. It was brilliant. It set up for the rest of the end credit scene. Then you've got the unicorn, you get the rainbow with the money. It's just beautiful.
Yeah, the rainbow, I actually had to change for an international version. So if anybody saw an international version, something is tweaked there. So it's kind of fun to see how different areas actually interfere with some of the animation later on down the road. It's pretty funny, but that's my favorite shot, and that's what everybody else loves. They're like rainbow shot, the rainbow shot.
Do you feel that your character that you develop is safe enough for a younger generation to maybe give you a script?
I would love to see a cartoon of our work.
In that form, you can take it in any direction. Yeah, didactic, you can be goofy.
There's a certain level of violence that you can do with the animation where it's not too much and offensive to the kids, but it can also be fun.
Yeah, and I'm always surprised when somebody comes up to the table and it's a younger kid, and they're so drawn to it because it's so naive. Like, we can be doing those things, but it comes across so playful in a way. And I hope that we can do number two, obviously. We're going to push really hard for it. And it seemed like the fans really liked it a lot, so I think we have a good shot. And, I mean, the cartoon, if Fox and Marvel would contact us about that, or even us,
let's tell it to the fans. Hey, you guys here, they're excited to possibly
be in the cartoon.
Yes. To possibly be in the end credits of Deadpool 2. If you'd like to see a cartoon series for yourself or for your kids, get out there on social media and let Marvel and Fox know, hey, we want a cartoon series from Justin.
Don't we want us to do it, yeah.
Yes.
Send it to Korea.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
Send it to, like, Georgia or whatever.
Totally correct.
So, outside of creating exciting content for Fox Culture, what else do you guys like to do? Are you guys adrenaline junkies?
That's
bad. Are you guys cinema fellas?
I used to.
You do a lot of stunt stuff.
I used to, yes. Yeah. Used to do a lot of hardcore skateboarding. Everything just becomes too injury prone. We're like, okay, let's stick to tennis and volleyball and long shots, mosh pits.
Yeah, some skateboarding stuff to mosh pits.
Mosh pits are long run. Yeah, long. It can't keep me out of the pit.
And Justin?
I just kind of bike around and play a lot of Fallout 4. Is that bad? Yes. No, I haven't been for so long, and then I saw Fallout 4. My little brother got it for me for Christmas, and I go, I'm not going to play it. I played it, and now I can't stop. My wife is like, hey, I remember the time when you didn't always just play the Fallout. And I go, I don't remember. I'm level 62.
Time and I have started messing with me. My memory started resetting. I haven't played video games.
Dude, with this. Now that would be killer. Jumping, I mean.
Oh, that would, yeah.
That would, an 8-bit side-scroller, done in this style. I mean, that would be right.
What do you guys think about that? An 8-bit side-scroller with this Deadpool character. Let us know. Tell us on the site. So, from here at Comicpalooza, we're Geek Culture Live. We'll see you geeks at the con. See you.